This is the English Literature Web YouTube channel and I am Professor L.B. Gayakawad is teaching today the topic Character Sketch. This is the Lecture 8 and Part 2. The character sketch is called a thumbnail portrayal of a person. Remember, when we discuss about the character sketch, then we can say that this is the thumbnail. That is, this is the symbol, this is the sign, or this is the identification, this is the portrayal, that is, this is the picture, this is the reality of the lifeful or lifeless persons in the society. If we capture the physical features of the person innerly and outwardly, we can perform the character sketch or the character sketch very exactly. Remember, here there are some conditions and these conditions are very much important. When we are sketching that character, we must think of the physical features of that person. And we should think of those physical persons innerly and outwardly. Means it means we must think innerly, we must think outwardly. Means we have to be united with that character. And we should think of that character innerly, means how that character behaves innerly, we should try. Then outwardly also we should try to see or to study that character. And we should ourselves also be united with that character's feelings of inner sense and the feelings of outward sense. We can perform the characteristics exactly in this way. Otherwise, we cannot give the justification to the character sketch and we cannot write the beautiful character sketch, and our readers will not be satisfied with the explanation of our character sketch. We have to describe the exact physical appearance. Remember, we should write down, we should study, watch, we should find out exactly the physical appearance of that character. Means the character is how outwardly, or how that character appears, or how that character looks. That is called the physical, exact physical appearance. That is regarding the tallness of that character, means how that character is tall, then how that character is short, that is the shortness, means the total figure, the total body of that character should be written down by us or by the writer, then and that will be the real exact description of that character, and that will be the character sketch. Then which are the disabilities with that character, how that character is unsuccessful with the help of the disabilities, that all these things we should write there. Thus the writer can write or describe the character analyzing the features, qualities of the physical appearance, and thus only we can shape the character sketch properly. We can count there the psychological traits of the characters, like emotions, feelings, desires, somewhat nature, anger, happiness, etc. Tiredness, depressedness, sadness, and all the situations which are running with the character. It means that here we have to think of that character psychologically, means we have to find out the qualities of that character's psychologically, means how he behaves, how his mind behaves, or how his feelings are, or desires are, or how he has the culture, or how he puts his faith in something or in some matters. All these things we have to see. And how he behaves with others psychologically, all these things should be seen by us, should be written down by us, and then it will be the really successful character sketch of that person. The writer should analyze the physicality on the basis of likings and dislikings, then lovings, then distastes of that character, then hatreds of that characters, and then preferences of that character. Remember, when the writer is going to write down the character sketch of that particular person, that writer must see the likings. Likings means what things are liked by that character, or how that character likes those things, or what are the things which are loved by that character. That also should be considered by that writer. Then what are the tastes of that writer, what he likes or what he hatred, hates, or what are the hatreds of that character. Hatreds means what he likes, what he does not like, that is the hatred. And what is his preferences, means how he prefers the matters in his life. All these things should be written down by that writer. Nowadays, the character sketches are found in the writings of the satiric novelist like Thomas, Pynchon. So remember, there is the writer, that is the Thomas Pynchon, in the particular novels of this gentleman, the satiric character sketches are now seen very nicely, because this writer has tried to see all these characters very nearly, very closely, and he has studied them very minutely, and that's why they have become really the character sketches of the life, and they have been very much useful for the researchers and the readers. They are presented through television serials and movies in the form of dramatic and comedic positions. Remember, all these characters are shown as the character sketches in the serials of the TVs, then in the films and the movies, and also in the forms of the dramatic situations. Means dramatic situations means they have been shown very much, with the help of the magics, or dramatically, it means that they have been shown as the different type of characters in society, and then they have been shown very comically in the life. So remember, today also we have finished here the lecture 8 regarding the character sketch, its characteristics, and this was the part 2. Again, we will come in front of each other with a new topic. Till then, thank you very much.